Alrighty, today we're going to talk about a pressure switch. So this little gray box right here, you'll see on most well systems. This is what we refer to as a pressure switch. This is what's going to turn the well pump on and turn it off. This little guy right here is what we call a low pressure cutoff. That's designed so if the pressure in the pipe drops below 25 psi, rather than having an issue with your pump burning up or flooding your basement, this one disengages the power so you don't have to worry about the pump continuing to run. So how this works, you have your nipple right here that's going to have the pressure from the pipe come up. These springs are going to read that pressure, and then it'll engage the contact plates in, which will connect the house power to the pump power, and then the pump will turn on, and then it'll compress the pressure tank itself. When you're trying to figure out how much air pressure you're going to be working with, if you look on the bottom left, you'll see that it says on 30, off 50. That means that this is a 30-50 switch. So what'll happen is when the air pressure in the tank drops to 30 psi, those plates will engage, the pump will pump, 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 until 50 psi and disengage. Usually you'll see a 20-point swing, so whether it be 30-50, 40-60, or 50-70, or even 20-40, that's usually your main variance. So let's just say that you lose power and your pressure drops below 25 psi. What you need to do is you need to hold this up, and that will push the contact plates in, which will then help to build the pressure in the pipe to get it to where the pump goes back to its auto setting. Super important, before you call a plumber, come down here, check this if you have one.